This is going to be the second video about word problems that are solved with quadratic equations. And what I want to do this time is something called a projectile problem. Now, projectile problems are simply things that are thrown or hit or launched into the air. So a baseball is a projectile, a basketball, a rock that's thrown into the air, a rocket, anything like that is a projectile. So here's the problem. A projectile is launched from a tower into the air with an initial velocity of 48 feet per second. Its height, h, in feet, above the ground, is modeled by the function h equals negative 16 t squared plus 4 sub o t plus 64, where t is the time in seconds since the projectile was launched, and v sub o is the initial velocity. And then it asks us three questions. How long was the projectile in the air? When did it reach its maximum height? What was its maximum height? Okay, I know this looks kind of scary, but it doesn't have to be. It's just a lot of words, and we're given a lot of good information. We're given this formula. So let's look at the formula. H, we're told that H is height. If something is flying through the air, it's going to have some height. So this formula is going to tell us what the height is in terms of t, because we've got h equals negative 16 t squared, and we're told t is time. Well, that makes sense, because as time goes by, it goes up and then it comes down again. And then it has this v sub o, okay? And it says v sub o is the initial velocity. Well, we're told what the initial velocity is. The initial velocity is 48 feet per second. So let's rewrite this with the 48 in there, okay? So we're going to have h equals negative 16 t squared plus, and instead of v sub o, I'll have 48 t plus 64. And then the question asks us, the first one is, how long was it in the air? Well, it was in the air until it hit the ground. And when it hit the ground, its height was zero. So I'm going to take this original equation and I'm just going to set it equal to zero. Okay, so what do we have here? It's just a quadratic equation that we can solve. Now, looking at it, we've got these big numbers, 16 and 48, 64. So you might want to try the quadratic formula, but let's take a look at the numbers. They're all even, so I could divide out a 2 from this whole thing. In fact, I could divide out a 4. All these numbers are divisible by 4. And if we go even further, we're going to see that we could divide a 16 into each of these numbers. So if we do that, we get a very simple equation. Let's divide, actually, a negative 16. We'll get this negative sign out of the way, too. So if I divide all of this by negative 16, I'm going to have just a t squared plus negative 16 into 48. That's not a plus anymore. That's negative 3t. And negative 16 into 64 is negative 4. So now all I've got is this negative 16, which I don't have to worry about. I have to keep writing it, but I don't have to worry about it, times t squared minus 3t minus 4 equals 0. So let's factor this quadratic equation in the middle of it here. So I have negative 16, and then I'm going to have a t and a t, and I've got a negative 3 in the middle and a negative 4 at the end. So I know I want one positive number and one negative number, and I can make a 4 with a 1 and a 4, 1 times 4, and the difference between 1 and 4 is 3, so those will be good numbers. So let's put a 1 here and a 4 here. I'm going to make the 1 positive and the 4 negative. That'll give me a negative 3t in the middle. Okay, now, I don't have to worry about the negative 16 anymore because I know that that doesn't equal 0. So either t plus 1 equals 0 or t minus 4 equals 0, or both of them equal 0. So let's say t plus 1 equals 0, and t minus 4 equals 0. So now that means t equals negative 1 or t equals 4? Well, I don't want a negative time, so this negative 1 is not going to work. So it seems like the projectile is going to hit the ground after 4 seconds. So that's the answer to the first part of the problem. Okay, let's go back and see what the other two questions were. When did it reach its maximum height, and what was its maximum height? Okay, so let's erase this and just have the basic equation that we had. H equals negative 16 t squared plus 48 t plus 64. We want to know when it reached its maximum height. Well, this thing was a parabola. It went up and it came down. So if we want to find its highest point, we're basically looking for its vertex. That's when it reaches its maximum height, its highest point. So let's see, what's the vertex of this quadratic equation? Well, the vertex is going to be, remember the vertex formula is negative b over 2a. Well, b is 48, so negative b is negative 48. A is negative 16, 2 times negative 16 is negative 32. And I can reduce this whole thing to 3 halves, or 1.5. So after 1.5 seconds, the projectile was at its maximum height. Now, it also asked me what the maximum height was. Well, the maximum height is going to be how high it was after 1.5 seconds. So let's just put 1.5 in wherever I've got a t. So the height is going to equal negative 16 times 1.5 squared plus 48 times 1.5 plus 64. Let's see what that comes to. So this is going to be negative 16 times 1.5 times 1.5 is 2.25, because 15 squared is 225. And 48 times 1.5, or 1.5 times 48. So let's see, half of 48 is 24. 48 plus 24 is 72. Plus 64. And now I need 2.25 times negative 16. Well, let's see what I can do. I know that's going to be negative. 2 times 16 is 32, and 1/4, 0.25 of 16 is 4. So 32 and 4 is 36. So that's negative 36 plus 72 plus 64. And what does that equal? Well, 36 from 72 is 36, and 36 plus 64 is 100. So its maximum height is going to be 100. Now, and of course, if you wanted to, you could take this information, you could take this equation and put it into your calculator. And you would also find out when it hit the ground. That would be one of the zeros. That would be the point in your calculator. That looks like that. And you could find what the vertex is by using the maximum function in your calculator. And that would give you the 100 for the height. It would give you the 1.5 for the seconds, and so on. I just wanted to show you how to do it mathematically. Okay, so that's about it for now. Take care. I'll see you next time.